The video will RTMP live streaming will become the HDMI. Oh, I turn off the audio. Okay, I turn off the audio. This one. Okay, so the wireless MEVO Start with the Atem Mini Pro.
Everyone who watches my channel often must know that I do not encourage everyone to use wireless cameras as live broadcast equipment, but there are still some occasions where you must use this wireless camera. For example, you are doing this at a wedding banquet venue for live broadcast, you may need a wireless camera. For example, this is just the DJI Pocket 2. The topic we are going to introduce today is how to convert this wireless camera to HDMI and connect it to the video switcher. After wireless camera is converted to HDMI, you can connect to the HD1, HD2, HD3, HD4 of switcher. The biggest problem with this method is the problem of interference. The wireless signal is 2.4G, then you must first connect to the wireless router. This is the wireless router. The distance in this section is a risk, because how many people in this space use 2.4G, they will be interfered. So sometimes some people use this kind of wireless things and feel that it will be stuck. That is because of the problem of interference. The interference is unpredictable when watching the Wi-Fi on your occasion. Is it messy enough? If there is enough, then it can easily be disturbed. Today's video will tell you how to convert this DJI Pocket 2 wireless camera into an HDMI connection switcher. This is the first topic, and the second topic, I will tell you how to turn this MEVO Start, which is a MEVO Start camera, into a wireless camera, and then connect it to the video switcher. The third one I will tell you is how to use an iPhone. The iPhone is actually a good one. The camera iPhone is also used as a wireless camera. Connect to this video switcher, no matter what method is used. The biggest risk is that the interference of 2.4G is the interference between the wireless and the router. The method I want to use today is to use HDMI wireless transmission, TXRX. If it is like this iPhone, it can be connected to this HDMI output and you can use the wireless transmitter. But like this DJI Pocket 2, itself does not have an physical interface. How can you become a wireless transmission? One way to tell everyone is the so-called RTMP to HD adapter. The concept is like this. For example, if you like this kind of DJI Pocket R, it can do the built-in Facebook live broadcast or YouTube live broadcast. Because it can do this live broadcast, the function I use today is the so-called internet live broadcast function to broadcast the DJI Pocket to a device. This device is called an RTMP to HD adapter. This device broadcasts live to this device. After receiving the stream, the device converts it into HDMI output, HD output, and then connect to the switcher in the same way as above. This MEVO Start can also do live broadcasts by itself. He can do Facebook live broadcasts and YouTube live broadcasts. Of course, he can also do internet live broadcasts. I will broadcast this internet live broadcast to this box. This box receives the live streaming signal and converts it to HDMI to connect to the switcher. The same is true for this iPhone. Let's first introduce this DJI Pocket to convert it to HD and then connect it to the video switcher. My idea is to live broadcast this to. What is this box? This box is called an internet RTMP to HD adapter. And after receiving the live broadcast of the internet, he converts it to the end, then connects to the video switcher. The URL of the device is this IP address. So, the settings of your router should also match it. You need to set it to this IP address. It needs the same network domain to use it. After setting, we will connect the power supply and connect the wireless. The Ethernet network is connected to this state network is connected to the router. You will see that there is a Fabon logo. You will see the Fabon logo. Well, then connect the HDMI to your Atem Mini Pro. Next, we will make the settings for the DJI Pocket to broadcast live to this box. I use an iPad. You can also use an Android phone or an iPhone. Well, I open the DJI software and connect it. The more important thing is that it says DJI Pocket to you. You must buy this all-round controller to be able to do live broadcast. That is to say, when you use DJI Pocket 2, you should test it first to see if you can do Facebook Live or YouTube Live first. You can do Facebook Live or YouTube Live before you can continue to play. Okay, let's go ahead and add it. Do you see the screen? This screen is from the screen of this DJI Pocket 2. Then there is an option called live streaming. So choose this RTMP. This starts. And then the first one is to choose your router. The name of this router is this one. And then enter the URL of your RTMP. Is this RTMP? IP address, and then you choose this. 6 MB. This time, please wait for 20 seconds after you choose, because this device is about to connect to him. You have to wait 20 seconds. And after 20 seconds, press this button to start the live broadcast. After that, your TV will have a picture. And when you see the picture, it will come out at
声音有的
Hi
好，你看了，这样就可以了，搞定了。
This time, your DJI Pocket R1 will be live broadcast to this box. This box is converted to HDMI and connected to your video switcher Atem Mini Pro. You don't have to use Atem Mini Pro. You can also use other brands. You can do it like this. You can transfer all the functions you want, and you can convert it. You have to pay special attention to the problem of interference, because this thing, if your router is wireless, this part will interfere. If this part can be overcome, the picture will be smooth and no problem. Then I will introduce how to convert the camera of MEVO Start to HDMI output, and then connect it to the switcher. Live broadcast to this RTMP to HDMI adapters, internet live broadcast. Then this box will convert the RTMP stream to the output, and then connect to this switcher. Turn on the power first. Then, open your app. There is an app called MEVO. When it is connected, there is a little bit here to press to set. And then there is a place to turn off the beta mode first, to turn off the USB mode and turn it off. There is a live broadcast button here, and there is a let's take a look at RTMP IP address. Test E4 RTMP live broadcast and save it. Here, there is a live broadcast to start. And you can see the screen at this time, your MEVO Start becomes a wireless D connection to the switcher. Of course, this MEVO Start can be used to apps on your iPad.
EPTZ 这样子 这样
Next, I will tell you how to make the iPhone into a wireless camera and then connect it to the video switcher. I don't use the HDMI output method here. I use the internet, the way of live broadcast, of course. The iPhone can also be used as a wireless camera to connect to the switcher. First of all, you need to connect your iPhone to the router and connect it to the router. Seeing That is good here. Let's open an app. It's called Media Link Live. It's good to open this Media Link Live. There is a setting here too. Add a new one. You can add a RTMP live broadcast. After you add it, you will find that. You can hit the same URL here. RTMP IP streaming. Then you choose the resolution you want to live broadcast and your unsourced rate. Because it is an internet live broadcast, you can choose a higher one. I choose 1000 like this, then 4HD back. And then press this live broadcast. RTMP 2D. This the iPhone will broadcast live to this box. This box is converted into HD and then connected to the switcher.
影像的。 Hi. 我们听到声音 有吧？ 对不对？ 好， 全萤幕看一下。 哦， 就这样， 这直播。 iPhone.
The wireless camera is connected to the switcher. We have introduced three ways how to turn a wireless camera into an HD connection to the switcher. Of course, I still have to tell everyone that it is a risk to use a wireless camera to do live broadcast because the camera itself is going to the router to use 2.4G. This segment is a very dirty channel and may be interfered with by your router. His professionalism and his reception will affect the smoothness of your video. Because my router says his wireless signal is of very good quality, so you can see his picture quality is very smooth. You see it's very smooth, you do. And see any problems, it's very smooth. It doesn't mean that all routers are so smooth. So you have to be very, very careful when choosing a router. Thank you.